Okay, I'm here again with Pastor Hector at this facility. And so, tell me, this young man's name, he's 14, and what is his name?
Tu nombre?
Iván Yacir.
Iván?
Iván Garcia.
Garcia, and he's from Honduras?
Sí.
Sí, in Honduras?
Brian Duván.
Brian?
Brian.
So, tell me your story. How'd you get here from Honduras?
¿Puedes darme tu historia cómo veniste? ¿Por qué veniste
de Honduras? Talk loud.
So dame tu historia, ¿cómo llegaste aquí y por qué llegaste? ¿Cuál es tu destino?
No, pues ahorita ya la segunda vez que vengo ya.
Well, to me is the second change.
Second chance.
Coming over here.
Okay.
La primera vez que me vine, llegué hasta Nuevo Laredo, pero la pasada no nos agarraron los setas y estaban pidiendo $300 por cabeza.
Oh, wow. The first time that I come over here, I got to New Laredo, but I had the setas
took his money,
took the money, and then they just took a week back home.
Okay.
Entonces no lo pude pagar, entonces de ahí se me dificultó. Y estuve viviendo en la casa del inmigrante 4 días y
I don't have the type of money so they can give it to them, so they thanks God that they let me go, and then I went and lived to a immigrant house.
Okay.
Dificultó, entonces no lo pude pagar, entonces ahí conocí una mujer de que vive en Dolores Hidalgo. Y estuvimos viviendo un tiempo en Dolores Hidalgo.
So in the immigrant house, I met this lady. She's trying to help me,
right?
Just go with her and live with her in Hidalgo.
Okay.
Entonces de ahí primero llegué y estuve. Una señora nos ayudó, entonces ahí primero empecé limpiando solares y así para hacer dinero.
I started working with that lady. That was my job. The job that I was doing, it was just clean like grass and around the houses, and so I can make some money.
Okay.
Y después con el poco dinero que hacía, entonces ya pude, entonces conocí una señora que es la es amiga de la presidenta del pueblo.
In that time, the money that I collected and also found another lady, like this lady, president of the town.
Right, like the mayor.
The mayor of the town.
Yeah.
Entonces yo le expliqué que venía de Honduras y ella me preguntó cuántos años tenía. Entonces yo le dije que tenía 13 años.
I spoke to her and she looking at me like I'm very young, so she coming to me and asked me how old I was, and I told them that I was 13 years old at that time.
Porque eso fue hace 2 años, entonces ella me explicó si quería seguir mi estudio, entonces yo le dije que sí, porque apenas ya había llegado al quinto grado.
The lady, she asking me if I wanted to continue being in school. Because
and this is in Hidalgo?
There was in Hidalgo.
Okay.
Hidalgo, Mexico?
Sí.
Yeah, there was in Hidalgo, Mexico.
Entonces, de ahí, ella me dijo de que qué tal iba con mis calificaciones. Entonces, yo traía un pedazo de que me hacía acostar que yo estaba en la escuela en Honduras.
So, I had also a paper that was showing that I was in the school in Honduras.
Right.
Entonces ella tres medios después nos fuimos haciendo amigos y
in the long we just come and being pretty good friends.
Okay.
Entonces de ahí después ella ya me fue teniendo más confianza y yo como le iba haciendo bastantes favores de aseo.
And you know my work that I was doing, she was kind of catching more trusting on me and
entonces ella me consiguió un permiso para yo seguir mi estudio y empecé a estudiar.
So she found me a permit so that I can continue to go into school in that area.
Okay.
Y empecé a estudiar, entonces gracias a Dios pues pasé mi escuela y pero hubo un problema con una señora de ahí porque ella no quieren los extranjeros, y ella se dio cuenta que nosotros éramos de Honduras.
In the time that I found, it was a lady, she was looking at me, and then I started making, you know, problem because
right.
her, they was like, not like people from other countries.
Right.
So I just got in myself in trouble.
Entonces ella, entonces, como, no sé por qué le caí mal, entonces nos echó la migración.
I have not know why she was looking at us like with no good eyes.
And this was here in Mexico, right?
That was here in Mexico, so
right.
she was calling an immigration to us.
Wow.
Entonces nos,
was it that she wanted more money?
Esta mujer que necesitaba, quería dinero.
No, es que ella como como ella miró de que yo yo me ganaba las personas haciendo sus casas, y ella eso es lo que le
gustó. I believe that this lady, she was like, you know, that was doing a good job, good uh-huh. work, and this lady, she was from the mayor on the colonia, and I don't know what happened, but I don't keep
yeah
getting good to her.
Let me ask him.
Déjame decirte.
Let me ask him a couple of questions.
How
was it in? You're from Honduras, right?
Tú eres de Honduras, ¿verdad?
Sí. Okay. And you left Honduras.
¿Tú dejaste Honduras? ¿Por qué dejaste Honduras?
Better here than in Honduras.
¿Está mejor aquí que en Honduras?
Sí, pues ahorita esa fue la primera vez. Ya ahorita es la segunda vez y la primera vez y esta es la segunda vez que dejé Honduras fue por la economía y superarme en el estudio.
This is my second change because I know that my country is not a well. Be honest with you and I can see that I'm looking at a better
okay.
better future.
Okay, so he wants to come to the United States.
Entonces tú quieres llegar a Estados Unidos.
Sí, para
to work. To what?
Tú quieres llegar a Estados Unidos para trabajar.
Sí, para trabajar y sacar adelante a mi familia.
Yes, I want to enter to United States to work and take my family, you know, given a better future.
Okay.
Entonces ya también me vine por el problema de las pandillas porque
also I left you Honduras because it's a cartel, you know, and okay. in my country they take us and put them to
kidnap the cartel kidnaps
them.
Okay.
Yes.
Porque ahorita están recolectando bastantes jóvenes para trabajar de sicariato y matanza.
Right now they up to the younger guys so they can train it to work with the cartel.
Okay.
Yes.
And that's not something he wants to do, right?
Y eso tú no lo quieres hacer.
No. Okay.
Y este como ya poco una vez me agarraron porque yo juego fútbol y me agarraron saliendo del fútbol.
I love to play football, so I know they
which we call soccer.
Soccer, football, yeah. Soccer. So they cut me one time. I'd already been caught by them.
Entonces me agarraron dos jóvenes y me querían obligar a entrar a la pandilla. They
cut me and they trained me to work with the mafia 18.
Entonces, okay. Gracias a Dios me les pude escapar y entonces como allá uno la verdad uno si hace dos tiempos de comida es mucho.
Entonces, and thanks God because I take off and run and I know in my country it's not very easy. I can see there's another country like United States and even Mexico.
So he is fleeing the violence in Honduras.
Entonces tú lo que vas corriendo es la violencia de Honduras.
Sí.
Yes.
Okay. And he's fleeing the violence in Honduras and trying to get in the United States.
Y tú tratas de entrar a Estados Unidos.
Because he wants to work and have a life.
Porque quieres trabajar.
Sí, para.
He wants interested in being a United States citizen and doing it right.
Tú quieres ser estadounidense con tus papeles es tener una vida mejor.
Legalmente que no me vayan a deportar porque realmente por todo el camino los federales nos venían humillando y bastante humillaciones.
I've been suffering, even with that highway patrol, the Mexican highway patrol. And,
yeah, they're corrupt.
I know that my future is to have a good life,
amen.
A human good life. So,
amen.
Yes.
Okay, so tell him I wanted to record this.
Yo quiero grabar esto.
So that people can hear his story.
Quiero llevarlo para que la gente escuche tu historia.
Because in the United States we're hearing a lot of different news
Porque
things.
Porque en Estados Unidos se escucha otras historias diferentes.
And I wanted to see firsthand.
Y yo quiero que esta gente vean tu interior del corazón.
Sí, sí. And, Porque muchas veces cuando nos venían deportando, a veces no nos querían dar de comer y nos venían humillando y realmente no quiero seguir mi vida así.
My trouble trying to cross Mexico, I've been humiliated for a lot of people. They've been like immigrant. The way I've been.
She's been robbed. Through, yeah, have been you been robbed?
And yes.
Has he been?
Te han robado. Te han humillado.
Has he been beat up?
Te han golpeado. Te han golpeado.
Pues lo que se llaman el crimen organizado y las pandillas, no, pero sí peleas allá en la escuela porque muchas veces me quieren humillar por el estudio.
No for the cartel, the way that was coming through here, but in my country, in the school, trying to let us.
Did he ride the train up from Honduras?
En el tren, cuando tú te viniste en el tren.
¿La bestia?
Pues realmente en el tren no he venido, pero sí he experimentado la violencia allá en el país.
I was not traveling in a train, but I've been trying to jump in.
Okay, yes. Okay. Well, tell him that there are some Americans that care about him.
Quiere decirte que hay muchos americanos que sí se preocupan por ti.
And then we're doing our best to get a accurate picture of what guys like him are going through.
Y vamos nosotros a tratar de llevar ese cuadro de como personas como tú.
And that we want to help any way we can.
Y queremos nosotros ayudar de diferentes formas, pero.
Amen.
Y yo les agradezco a ustedes porque traen medicinas y apoyan al pastor con la iglesia y muchas gracias por lo que hacen porque realmente nunca nos habían tratado así y sí les quería dar gracias por lo menos que se importan por nosotros, que nosotros por lo menos valemos.
I want to, from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you because I see with my own eyes that y'all care for people like us. They come from the United States and coming to Mexico and take our pains and coming to this ministry and give us a medical and give us all kind of supplies. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Well, God bless you, brother. We don't do near enough, and I haven't done anything, but God bless you.
Que el Señor te bendiga porque lo que nosotros lo hacemos es para el Señor Jesucristo.
But I just want to share a story.
Pero yo quiero compartir esta historia y la voy a compartir.
Okay, so here we have a 14-year-old boy that's from Honduras. That's made his way up. Been in Mexico, been in and out of all kinds of stuff, and he just wants to get to the United States. He wants to do it legally. He just wants to work and make a better life for himself, and he's fleeing the violence in Honduras. So this is somebody that we have actually met, not somebody we heard about on the news, not somebody that we read about in the newspaper. I just met this young man, and so I'm just doing my best to tell his story.